Somebody who's been on our show a few times
has
made a big list, right?
Yes, there are a few locals that are making very big news.
Mm-hmm.
Named to Forbes 30 Under 30 for being young game changers. Very cool. And there were a total of 15,000 nominations, narrowed down to 600 of the brightest young stars making a difference in 20 different categories. Hence, 30 Under 30,
mm-hmm.
if you do the math. Okay?
So among them, you may recall Alexandra Clark. She's made the category of food and drink, top 30 under 30, and you may recognize her because she's been here on the show a few times. She's with Bon Bon Bon. She's a 27-year-old chocolatier who founded the company, and she is the first artisan chocolatier to set up shop in Detroit in 40 years.
Wow,
and every one of those is a little piece of art.
Right.
They're wonderful.
A little bit of deliciousness.
Yeah.
We enjoyed her. So, and guess who else made the 30 under 30?
Hmm?
I don't know, this guy right here.
Matt Gaedeke.
Yeah.
Come on. I think I have to get, you know, we have to put a little asterisk after the entire script. He is the son of Chuck and Susan Gaedeke and the brother of four other siblings and Grandma and Grandpa and Warren. So here he is, top 30 under 30 in America. Let me rub up against you. Let me make
so
sure.
Cool.
Come well, thank on. You
so
for having me.
I have to bring this up.
Yeah.
So did you really just text your dad and let him know that you made 30 under 30, like
BTW? I didn't even know. I came back from a trip and I had an email. You know, they contact you like way before and you know, get some information and a photo. And I came back to like a few emails that were like, hey, you know,
that's
this
awesome.
Happens.
Well, let me explain from a dad's point of view, right? So he's off the grid for what, 12 days?
Two weeks
in Chile, right? He's in Patagonia. And we're following the little map he gave us. So every day we can't talk to him.
Mm-hmm.
We just know he's out there by himself with some of the stuff he'll explain. And then he gets off the plane. All we wanted to know, are you home? I'm home. And I've made Forbes 30 Under 30. It's like, what?
This guy, that's so cool to me. That's so cool. So tell us all about why you were honored by Forbes.
So, you know, I think it represents this, like, interdisciplinary journey that I've taken from writing software in Silicon Valley and now working at the University of Michigan on Parkinson's disease, right? So it's been from electrical engineering and robotics now to, you know, looking for treatments to disease. And so they all bridge in this really unique way, and I think Forbes, you know, somehow appreciated that.
That's very cool.
Yeah.
Very cool.
He's written a book on the brain. I volunteered to let him use my brain as the example, but it didn't qualify.
It's a little small.
So,
tell us about the book. This is
all right,
cool.
So what is all this stuff? Is this some of the stuff you took with you to Patagonia? Tell us where Patagonia is so we understand.
Yeah, so Patagonia is this region in Chile and Argentina. So it kind of spans along southern South America.
Mm-hmm.
And this is like a day pack. So these are all the things that you know, short of a jacket that you might want to take to survive.
Okay.
And so over here is like the storytelling equipment, right? That's most important to me, right?
It's your journal?
And the journal.
The journal, yeah.
Okay.
Recounting everything. And then you have a small stove that runs off propane, a titanium spoon, a simple headlamp, you know, from Home Depot. And these are all things that, like, you could use up north. You know, these are things that I take up there as well. A water filter, although all the, you know, fresh streams in Patagonia and Torres del Paine National Park were okay just to drink straight from. And then, you know, I'll let your imagination roll with those. And dry socks, of course, wool socks.
And let me stop you there because for Christmas, Mom Gaedeke gave Matt two pairs of socks.
These haven't been washed, by the way.
Yes, they look like they're standing up. Yeah. Okay, so that's good. That's really good.
You've got some pictures, right?
Yeah.
Let's take a look. So tell us what we're seeing.
Oh, my gosh.
So this is a puma. So pumas are indigenous to
this area of Chile. Oh.
And I was running along a path, and up to my left, this puma was actually on a hunt of one of these animals that is cousin to the llama there.
Mm-hmm.
So
wow.
One of those was up on a hill, and I saw the puma pop out, and we kind of shared a moment there.
And then did you get the heck out of Dodge after that?
Yeah, I started running a little bit faster.
Nice.
So these are the spires. These are kind of quintessential Patagonia. It's a big climb, a big morning for everyone. You know, this was a morning after a blizzard, believe it or not, that came through. So the weather changes like crazy.
Gorgeous.
This was along the backside. I was doing some science alongside another organization.
And is that your tent?
No, my tent's going right next to that one, though. That was just when I showed up.
Okay.
And this is a moonlight valley there.
So you took the camera gear with you, but you also were able to, you had a little track that you had just gotten before you left before Christmas, right? So we've got some video that's pretty cool.
Let's check that out.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I had an entire, you know, backpack full of tripods and glass and
cool
my camera. And so this is capturing what's called the candle lighting of the spires. And here's a a waterfall that you pass by.
That looks like National Geographic.
Yeah, and this stuff is just, it's around, you know, it's every corner. You know, there's something new and cool to look at and something exciting. So
we've got to ask what's next for you in this coming year, because we know you're headed to Russia pretty soon and you're presenting something.
Right? Yeah. So Russia's a conference, a neurobiology conference, and I've collaborated with the Department of Aerospace Engineering on what's called a CubeSat. And so it's the satellite that's about the size of a loaf of bread.
There it is.
And yeah, there we go. So what we're designing and what we're proposing is the satellite that can be sent up for relatively cheaply, and we can do biological experiments inside of this little loaf of bread satellite, which
it's
is
very
amazing.
Cool.
So
it's
I amazing. Have to tell you, because I think I know, you really not only want to deploy that off the International Space Station, you want to be on the ISS, don't you?
I think that would be pretty cool.
Clearly you're adventurous like your dad,
Just text us and let us know you made it to space. Love you.
No, this
Thank
is
you.
Congratulations. So cool. Like, you make it look really easy, and he's so chill, but it can't be. But anyways.